Welcome to Exo Magic Trick number 698. Hey, if you want to download this workbook and follow along, click on my YouTube channel, then click on my college website link, and you can download the workbook, Exo Magic Trick 698 to 702. Wow, we got a doozy here with lots of tricks put together to accomplish one thing. There's a little application right here, and we just have a data set. We're just entering records, and we want a unique list of our customer names, so that a data validation drop-down list somewhere else shows only the unique list of names. So when we add our records day after day, if we add Chin, and this is a new customer, we not only want this list to update, our unique count to update, but we want our drop-down to update, only showing unique values. This is going to involve a bunch of tricks. And some of them are quite complex. I have a bunch of reference videos down here. We first have to do a define name that will pick up any new values added to the full list. We'll do that and put it in define name. Then we need to count unique items. We need to extract only the unique names from this list, see the repeats. We then need to create a dynamic range define name formula for the unique list, and then finally use that define name in data validation. All right, let's go ahead and see how to do this. First thing is we need to have a dynamic range. So as we add, whoops, that's not supposed to be there. So as we add new records, the range for customers will expand. When doing define names, sometimes it's easier to create them in the cells first. Now instead of offset function for define names, I'm going to use index. And we can do that by selecting the first cell in the range. And I'm going to hit F4, because this formula is ultimately going to be put up into define names dialog box. I'm going to type a colon, and that messes that up. So if I highlight this and hit F4 again, now I can hit colon. Now, we really want it to be, for this particular data set, C5 to C9. But if we add new records, like down here, we need it to be from C5 to C10. No problem. We can use the index function to look up a cell reference, an index. You usually use index. It's a lookup function. And you look up values. Like right now, you'd look up the last value, which is Mo. But when it's in the context of a cell reference, meaning cell reference colon, and they're expecting a cell reference to complete the range of cells, index will return the cell reference. All right, so what's our array? I'm going to highlight just down to here, say. If you're doing this, you need to highlight way past where the maximum number of records will go. I'm going to hit F4. And what does index do? We just need to look up. That's the array, comma, and unlike VLOOKUP, index needs a row number and a column number. Well, we only have rows, so we just need our row number. Well, how can we get that? Well, no problem. Comma, oops. Sorry, we already have a comma. There's our screen tip. We'll just use COUNTA. COUNTA can count all of the names in that range. Again, that range has to be bigger than the maximum number of records you'd ever have. Now, right now, that'll give us 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. F9, you can see that gives us a 5. Control Z, and that'll work. Control, close parenthesis. Now I'm going to highlight this and test it. F9, perfect. If I had any more here, it would include them all. Notice, this is the name of the customer column with all the repeats. Control Z. Copy, because we're going to paste it up into define names. I'm going to enter this into the cell just in case I made a mistake and I have to come back and copy it. Control F3 opens define names. Now, I already have these created for the answer sheet. So when you download this, you can, if you make a mistake, you can go see. I'm going to click New and type Customers. Actually, I'm going to type do a capital C. It doesn't matter. But come down here, Control V. Click OK. Now, I'm going to test this. I can already see a problem. But if you don't see the problem, you always test it by clicking here. If it doesn't highlight the range, there is a problem. Uncollapse. The problem is, oh, look, and this is common with complex formulas in Name Manager or Define Name dialog box in earlier versions, it puts double quotes in sometimes. It's not smart enough to realize this should be a formula. It thinks it should be text. So I'm going to click and backspace. Now, you have to edit. But if you're editing it here, you can click the checkbox. Now I'm going to click collapse. And sure enough, now it works. I can see that it works. Click close. Now we can create our formulas. Now we first need to create a formula for unique count, 1, 2, 3. We should get a count of 3. And then our formula to extract. This would be complex array formulas. Now if, and I've done lots of videos on unique count, if we had wildcards, question mark, asterisk, in our data set, we'd have to use this unique count formula. If you don't, you don't have to get this complex. So we're not, because we're never going to have that. And plus, I always show this one, so I'll show a different formula. Not quite as robust, but if you're never going to have wildcards, this is a great formula for counting unique. Sum product. We're just going to use the first array here. We are going to first make sure that nothing is blank. So I'm going to do open parentheses. And now we need to use that customer's name. F3 is paste name. Double click. Anytime that is not blank, okay, that'll give us a series of trues and falses. Now, we need to somehow figure out where the unique ones are. Row 1, 2, and 4. So I go comma, divide by, and I'm going to use the COUNTIF. COUNTIF expects a range and criteria, but you can actually return an array of values, as long as you don't put an array into the range argument. So I'm just going to highlight this, or F3 customers. Now, again, we don't have any wildcards, so we just leave that one there, comma. And you got to put in the criteria, the same exact range, F3. Double click. And we need to deal with any time they're blank. So if we had a blank, like this cell was blank, there'd be a 0 there, because Excel would see blank and interpret it as 0. So we just deal with that by ampersand join symbol double quote. That's actually concatenating all the values plus blank. That converts everything to text. Well, everything is text already. Except for if there was a blank, then it would be 0. So concatenating this with a blank converts it to a blank. And there will be no divide by 0. Close parentheses. Now what does this give us? F9, 2, 2, 2. So you can see there's a 2 there because there's two Joes. 1 and then 2. The second entry here for Joe gets a 2 also. Well, that's no good. That we'll get a huge count. We really need 3. Well, what if we took these two 2s for Joe and divided it by 1. 1 divided by 2 is 0.5. 1 divided by 2 is 0.5. If you add those together, you get a 1. Same thing for Mo. So Control-Z, no problem. We already have that. These are trues and falses, F9. Anytime you take true divided by 2, it will give you, it'll be as if 1 divided by 2, it'll give you 0.5. So 0.5, 1 for Sue, 0.5 for Joe, and then 0.5, 0.5. Well, if you add all that together, you get 3. Control-Z. I'm going to close parentheses. Let's just take a look at this. You can highlight everything inside and hit F9. There it is, your 0.5s, 1s, etc. Control Z. Enter. You don't need a Control Shift because some product can handle arrays. Now let's do our next formula. And this is quite complex. I'll go fast because there's a reference video. If you want to learn about everything to know about unique count, this frequency video has a lot of stuff. It's a 50-minute video. Equals if. Now we need to check, because once we get past 3, we want to show blanks here. So I'm going to say rows. This will be our number incrementer. And I'm sitting in E7. So E$7 colon E7. Anytime that is greater than our count, F4, then what do we want? We need to show a blank. So the value of true is blank, comma. Now, our value of false is going to be our big nasty lookup formula that's going to look up only unique items. Index, the array, well, it's going to be our customer. So F3, double click that. That's the array, comma. And now the row number. Well, let's just look. We have 1, 2, don't need that one, 4. So ultimately, we need a we want 1, 2, 3, 4. As we go down, we want 1 here, then 2, then row 4 in the index. Well, we'll accomplish that with the small, because the small can take that array of 1, 2, 4, and give us from that array whichever k we want, which is the first smallest, second smallest, third smallest. Now I'm going to comma. That array is going to be the big nasty part, right? So this right here is our formula incrementer. So it will extract as we go down the row 1, 2, and then 4. That might get in the way visually. So I'll just go ahead and build this now. We're going to have to do if. All right, now we're going to need frequency. Now this is going to get a little tricky here. Frequency just has data array and bins. We somehow need to get 1, 2, and 4 rows. Well, we're going to have a bunch of data here and then some bins. And frequency will count unique. It'll ignore the times that there are duplicates. If, and then we have to put another if, and we have to ask, is that customer range not blank? Then what do we want? And match is going to be our key here. We use COUNTIF up here, but here we're going to need to use match, because match will give us the ordinal position, right? Hey, that's 1, 2, 4. Customer range, again, similar to the COUNTIF, F3. We're going to have to list the customers once, comma, and then twice. And to deal with divide by zero errors, we have to ampersand double quote, comma. And the match, we need to say exact match 0. And that is what will get us just the first occurrence. Because match, when it's looking up something, it will see the first one. But when it sees the second one, it'll ignore it because of this 0 exact match. Duplicates, it only takes the first one. Close parenthesis on that. Now, if not blank, then match. Let's just take a look at this match right here, F9. 1, 2, 1, 4, 4. Huh, exactly what we're interested in, except for there's duplicates. No problem, we can get rid of the duplicates. But that's the data. Those are the data. Control Z. All of these, F9. We don't need the falses, so close parentheses on that. All that data array right there is F9. So now we have that. If there was a blank, that first part would have helped it. But what are we going to do? That's the data array. No problem. We'll put the bins all the row numbers, and it will count within those bins. For the first position, we'll get a count of 2 because there's 1, 2 Joes. Control Z. Comma, we need our bins. We need row of customers. So F3, double click that. Row of that. Remember, we're trying to get row 1, 2, 3, but now it would give us 5, 6. That's not what we want. Minus the row of the first one, F4. That gives us 5 minus 5. We don't want that, so we add one back in. That right there, F9, gives us our bins. Control Z. Close parentheses on the frequency. Now let's check this out. This is totally cool. Frequency is just amazing. F9. 2, that's for the count of Joe. But it's not going to go to that second one. It puts the count of Joe, both of them, there. Well, what good is this going to do? That's a 2. No problem. The if, which this is that whole frequency thing, is just a tricky way to get the trues and falses for logical test, which means, hey, it's a unique value. Well, any number that's not 0 is considered true by the if. So Control Z, that whole big thing there, that's all it's doing. Comma. Now, if it's true, what do we want? Boom, we're trying to dump something into index. We just need the ordinal position or row number in our data set. Again, I've already done this once, so I don't need to do it again. I can copy this same thing again and Control V. Okay, so that's the value if true. All of that right there to get the value of true, which is the row numbers, into the small. Now let's check this out. You can just highlight all of this and hit F9, and it should give us 1, 2, 4. Wow, that's an elaborate way to get just the row numbers we need that we can dump into index to extract. Control Z. But we don't want all of them. There's an array of them. Control Z. So that's where we do, as we mentioned before, comma, and then this. Copy, Control V, close parentheses on the small. We have our row numbers. Control parentheses on the value of false. I mean the if, close parentheses there. Control Shift Enter. That's an array formula, so use Control Shift Enter. And there we have it. If we add, it will update. Now, one last bit, because this is the list we're interested in for data validation dropdown. We got to do the same thing as we did up here, but different range equals, meaning dynamic range paste into the name manager. I don't know how to get this to work. I'm going to go like that. So that and then index. Well, this one's going to be even easier. But the array, you do need to, however big this range is, it better be bigger than the maximum number of unique customers you would have. F4. That's the array, comma, and what row number do we need? Because remember, index is going to be looking up that cell reference. We already have it right there. Boom, F4. Close parentheses. Copy, and I'm going to enter this, Control Shift Enter, in case we have trouble, we come back. Control F3. New data validation. Dynamic range, come down here, Control V. It's probably going to do the same thing again when I click OK. No, it didn't. Look at that. Looks like I got it right. I don't see. Let's test it. Boop. And sure enough, there we go. So I click OK, or I click Close. And now I'm going to come over here. Alt-DL works in all versions. Tab, L for list, tab, F3. I'm so excited here. Let's see if this works. I have my fingers crossed. Click OK. OK, Sue. Now, if we enter today's records, and this is Chin, and I come over here, Control Center. OK, so we're hoping that your name will be at the bottom of this. And sure enough, there it is. So that was quite an elaborate process to get this drop down. But in some cases, although it takes a while to set up, you have your template. You can use it over and over. All right, we'll see you next trick.